rest for 2 weeks already. What are we looking for?
I am glad that you asked, Maya Princess. Since Doomhammer had no doubt planted spies in our ranks, I decided to keep our true objective to myself. But now, at long last, I can reveal the truth. After I awoke from my slumber, I spent months searching through Medivh's library for anything about the tomb of Sargeras.
What is this tomb, and where is it located?
The tomb contains the remains of an avatar of the Dark Titan Sargeras, the once master of Kil'jaeden himself. Long ago, the tomb was sealed, and the entire landmass was sunk beneath the ocean waves.
You intend to raise the entire tomb from the sea?
And this was the reason we needed the powers of the Elven Runestones?
Yes. And once I enter the tomb, I won't need the hoard anymore. And even the demons will bow to my will.
In the mountains and will reach the lake. According to reports, our armada is filling through the river Brightwater in Tirisfal. They will provide naval support for us when we get to Fenris Isle. Why don't we just kill these humans, War Chief?
I had a meeting with their chieftain, and they have agreed to let us through their territory without a fight if we spare them.
Betraying their own kind? These humans have no honor.
Terrorist Fall and the outskirts of the Wizard City of Dalaran are heavily fortified. Crossing the Lordamir Lake through Alterac was our best option. And with this new arrangement, we will arrive at full strength.
Where's the War Chief? I must speak with him at once.
Scratcher? What are you doing here? You should be in Quel'Thalas overseeing the siege of Silver Moon.
Gul'dan, his entire clan, as well as the Twilight's Hammer, have betrayed us. Silver Moon still stands, and the Armani have been pushed back into Zul'aman. He went west with his entire force.
The wretched warlock. He seeks to mock me? Undermine me? The Horde and everything we have accomplished here? I was wrong in sparing him, and now I will right that mistake. Zuluhed, Rend, Maim! We are yours to command, War Chief. Gul'dan and his fleet fled west. You will take 3 battalions of Black Rock and Black Tooth Grim Warriors, as well as Zuluhed's Dragon Maw. Pursue that vile traitor to the ends of the earth if you have to.
I will gather the troops, War Chief.
Destroy the renegade clans and return with the head of Gul'dan. It will be done, War Chief. I will use the skull of that filthy traitor as a reminder to never have dealings with dark sorcerers again, and to show everyone what happens when you cross the War Chief of the Horde.
These islands don't appear on any of our maps. But the course matches our spy's report.
Something is wrong about this place. It feels unnatural. Yes, I feel it too. And these ruins, they look elven, but different from what Utok has described. Zuluhed, what do you think?
They are very old, no doubt, and seem to be marked by very powerful magic. Perhaps this was once the beating heart of elven civilization on this world, much like Goria was to the ogres back on Draenor. As for the foul taint in the air, I sense something ancient. A power, a dark presence.
Is it Gul'dan? Do you see him?
My vision is clouded, just as these islands are shrouded in fog. But the stench of fell is unmistakable.
Then Gul'dan must be close. We must make haste.
The traitors have more than just a strong fleet on their side. We can expect to face Ogre Magi, Warlocks, and those new Death Knights as well.
We can count on such forces as well, Utok. Gul'dan has made many enemies, and he can't outrun them any longer.
Warriors, we will set up a camp here and then continue the hunt. Come what may, Gul'dan will die today.
Drakthul.
Zulu head. So, we've ended up on opposite sides. What will you do? Cut my throat and leave me to die?
Great idea. Kill him! Wait, brother. He may know where Gul'dan is.
You used to be a shaman, Drakthul. Is this dark path worth dying for?
I don't wish to die, Suluhen. But I obey Gul'dan because... because the weak must follow the strong.
But now, you are weak, and we are the strong. Tell us where Gul'dan is hiding, and we will spare your life.
I fear the Shadow Council's wrath, Suluhead. But if you destroy them, then I will tell you everything. They are channeling a terrible ritual on the nearby island. Kill them, and bring me the artifact that they are using.
The traitors are dead, and here is the artifact, as promised.
Thank you. Gul'dan's power is vast. These very islands were raised by him to find an ancient tomb, the final resting place of a monstrous dark titan. It is this titan's terrible power that Gul'dan now seeks.
A dark titan?
He was called Sargeras, the lord of an endless legion of demons. It is told that Sargeras was defeated and his tomb sunk beneath the ocean waves many centuries ago. It was Sargeras' demons that enabled Gul'dan to become what he is. It was Sargeras' demons who helped empower our chieftains all those years ago. All that we are, everything that we have done, can be traced to him. North of here is a great tower. That is the tomb I spoke of. It is there that you will find Gul'dan. It is there that you will most likely meet your end. You've got what you wanted. Now leave me in peace. I would like to live what I have left of my life in solitude.
Gul'dan is insane. His obsession with power will destroy this world as it did Draenor. Onwards, warriors. We end this now. Find him. Luktar, warriors!
Take his head in the name of the war chief.
Not so fast, little shamans.
You have to go through us first!
Rend! Maim!
These shamans have far more strength in them than someone so plump and lazy as you, ogre filth.
Ah, the Blackhand brats.
The two impotent sons of Blackhand.
Ah, Maim. If only your wits could match that forehead of yours. Maybe then you might have offered some challenge.
And Rend, you may have some of your father's cunning, but what use is that when even your sister could break you like a twig? No wonder the Horde believes that you two were not but dirty toddlers when Blackhand ordered his warlocks to aid you.
I'll cut you into pieces, you two-headed pile of fat. Is he dead? We need to be Sure. Agreed, brother. I take one head, and you take the other.
We have no time for this. Utok, return to the base and heal your wounds. Keep the ships in check until we return.
Damn it. I wanted that head. We will get them later. Now go!
Wrong. You seem to be on edge.
I have faced many great enemies throughout my life, Zulhead. Ogres, Arakoa, and once even a Genosaur. None gave me pause. But whatever is waiting for us down there...
There is no shame in fearing the unnatural, Ren. Steel yourself by remembering that we will face the horrors of this place together. Whatever happens, you will not stand alone. These are orcish runes. No doubt Gul'dan means to use them to find his way out again. Interesting. He describes his arrival to the tomb. There's no telling what kind of power Gul'dan and his minions have awakened in this place. We should be careful.
Agreed. Few things can make orcs scream like that. This is wrong. Enough talk. The honorless scum must pay for this.
Jaden's betrayal teach you nothing, little Orc.
You... But I watched you die. Not that it matters. Feel free to witness the moment of my greatest triumph, little Magi. But stand in my way, and I will gladly return you to the jaws of death.
Oh, foolish, pitiful creature. There is so much that he do not know. So much that he do not understand.
Pitiful? I will show you the meaning of...
Treasonous filth! You have never been loyal to anyone but yourself. Your arrogance has blinded you, and it has left you weak against those who truly tower above you.
Doomhammer. But... I don't understand. Have you forgotten who you were, Gul'dan? Frail, weak, and the dog of your clan. I have not forgotten, little warlock, because it is all that you have ever been. Weak.
Centuries past, I destroyed this foul avatar, sealed it in this eternal tomb to be forgotten by history. No being of this world could open it. Yet my victory was not complete. For when I felled him, his foul essence seeped into my soul, an unholy parasite gnawing ever so slowly until he corrupted my womb and my child.
No. Impossible.
We often wondered what became of Kil'jaeden's little puppets, of Manaroth's favorite pets. And then, broken,
confused, and sympathetically desperate.
Think they lost my trail.
You're not going anywhere, Zulet.
Rakmar. Rakmar Sharpfang? I almost didn't recognize you.
I am born a new Shaman. I now have more power than you could ever imagine. Praise be to Gul'dan's gift.
Your master is no more. Death Knight. He was slaughtered by the very powers he had sworn to serve. I have his head right here.
Such is the price of power. I will lead whatever's left of the Storm Reavers and find new glory.
Your allegiance belongs to the Horde. Submit to it or die where you stand.
My allegiance is my own, Shaman. Show me what you got.
May this place crumble and return to the seas forever.
go to the catacombs? It's scary!
You'll be safe there, child. Don't be afraid. The light will protect you, and your mother and siblings will have need of you in the halls below. Your duty is to them. Now go.
Sir Uther, we have locked the gates and prepared the ballistas.
Good. Order archers to mount the defense on the parapets. Lordaeron will not fall today.
Awaits your command.
Good. We need to capture Fenris Island and build a base near the gold mine. After we accomplish that, our assault on the capital can finally begin.
Fast are you raising, maggot? The siege of the capital begins at dawn. If you're not ready by then, the warchief will have your hides.
Dragonmon Blacktooth Green Sails. The carriers of my vengeance return at last. Give report. Now!
Greetings, War Chief. We lost many good warriors, but your will is fulfilled.
Good. My misguided mercy has now been rectified. This will be a reminder to anyone who would dare oppose my rule.
War Chief, we have captured some survivors from the Twilight's Hammer and the Stormreaver clans. They're begging for your forgiveness. Yes, War Chief. They surrendered after we destroyed their fleet and slaughtered their leaders. Gul'dan's betrayal has cost so much. In light of this fact, we thought it's wisest to deliver them to your court instead of slaughtering them outright. They're all untrustworthy traitors.
But you're right, Rend. The strength of our armies have decreased dramatically. Though it pains me greatly to admit it, one way or the other, the future of the Horde will be decided today. But those soldiers in the vanguard, their debt to us will be repaid in blood. As for the rest of them, the Death Knights will watch over them until I decide their fate.
What is our next objective, War Chief?
Terron Gorfin struggles with the siege of Dalaran to the south. I want you to throw all the forces that you have against that city. Rend and Maim will go with you.
Wouldn't we be more useful against the capital city?
No, Rend. The Violet Citadel of Dalaran serves as sanctum and haven to the mages of the Curantor. Once Lordaeron has fallen, Dalaran will be the last and the most dangerous barrier between the Horde and the subjugation of humanity.
It is good that we have saved our greatest weapon for just this moment. Dragons. A flock of them just joined in from the hatcheries of the Dragonmaw.
Yes, today the last bastions of humanity will burn in Dragonfire. Go now.
You shall not pass, twisted undead creature!
Your petty magic can't stop us, mate.
can see the Cross Island, the key point of the Dalaran's defense. Terran Gorfine has started the attack, but his forces are progressing slowly.
What is the best tactic we can use to defeat him?
There are three arcane observatories that are shielding the heart of the island, Violet Citadel. If we destroy them, the Kirin Tor defenders will lose their magical shielding.
And after that, we can sack the Citadel itself.
The Citadel is protected by the spell conjured by the Archmage. First, we need to kill him.
I will have great pleasure to slice him into pieces.
We need to use our forces wisely. Ships and towers are protecting the island.
Dragons will burn the defenses and prepare the site for our ground troops' arrival.
That'll be a blast!
The alabaster parapets of Lordaeron's capital loom before us in the distance. The proud, defiant armies of the Alliance stand resolute in their final, fleeting moments. All that remains is the shrill, clarion call to battle and the fulfillment of our destiny. The tides of darkness are now at hand.
Guards, to me!
Skies covering the ruined capital of Lordaeron. Their cowardly king is surrounded in his castle, and his doom is inevitable. Our success has led Orgrim Doomhammer, war chief of the Orcish Hordes, to elevate me to the station of warlord, thus giving me power and command of my own clan. Once the Alliance finally be crushed, all the survivors will be slain and cremated as is dictated by the rituals. Then, at long last, Azeroth and all of its lands will belong to the thunderous force known to those foolish enough to stand in its way as the Horde.